This is the United States of America, my country. A country where there was once something we call Camelot. And oh yeah, I remember those days real well. Those all too short days. It was in those days of Camelot that a young man named John Fitzgerald Kennedy became the 35th president of these United States. And he wasn't a perfect man, nor did he run a perfect campaign. But he did give every American a charge. I can almost hear those words today. Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country. John Kennedy once wrote a book, Profiles in Courage. And I sincerely believe that this president was the most courageous president this nation has known, literally giving up his life defending our Constitution. Our 35th president, he could not be bought nor swayed. A man of integrity that stood against some powers, some foreign influence powers to likes that most Americans will never comprehend. Every American today needs to ask, who assassinated our president? And it wasn't this patsy. We really need to know why. And it wasn't but 40 months later, another great American. American standing for freedom, was right and decent, and who wanted the absolute best for the people he represented and all Americans. But these other powers, they had other ideas. Robert Kennedy is running for president at this time, and like his brother before him and Martin, he could not be bought or swayed. What has happened since is that progressives representing these uber elite controlling financial families have got a firm grip on this nation. They have created change in this nation that unfortunately we have to believe in. 9.6% unemployment, factories closed all across America, average government employees with benefit earns double the average wage of a private sector employee. Our tax dollars pay for $1 trillion annually for social welfare programs. 29% of our total budget, while only spending 0.3% assisting private sector small business development. Meanwhile, there's other areas of the world without a hundredth of our resources that are astronomically prospering. The Federal Reserve Act was supposed to bring stability and security to America, but it has brought just the opposite to all Americans. The same private elite families that own the Fed own and control the central banks of many nations throughout the world, basically shifting our wealth to theirs by first in America creating massive, wasteful debt, then rolling off paper money out of thin air for that debt, and when that runs out, it's through a Ponzi scheme called Treasury Bonds. This is where the Fed will order our Treasury to roll up paper Treasury Bonds, and then have their other central banks, like in Malaysia, or Arab Emirates, or China, roll off paper money from their countries to pay for these treasury bonds, while the U.S. citizens pay all these banks back out of our tax dollars and with interest. This is the world's greatest Ponzi scheme. This all makes no sense. America has more natural resources than any nation on earth. Americans are the hardest workers and have the highest productivity rate of any nation on earth. America is the most innovative nation of people on earth. This makes no sense. We saw a ray of hope in 1980 with the election of President Reagan. 69 days into his presidency, a bullet lodged 2 inches above his heart sent an all-too-clear message. Please join me in this effort to take back our nation. United, we can stand against these uber-elite banking families that literally want to control and own every fiber of our life.